our relationship with nature and how we're using nature, the minerals, the trees, the, you know, how we convert land to farmland, it's all usurping nature for our needs. When I was born, it was 2.5 billion people in 55, and I look today and there's now over 8 billion people. So we've almost added a billion people per decade in my life. And so in that growth, I also understood that the subject that I was photographing was going to be ever expanding, that it would continue to get bigger and bigger and bigger. I started to look at the scale of humanity and the consequence and the residuals of that scale, the places where we would take things and then just leave them as wastelands and go on to the next thing. So I looked at those wastelands. In the 40 years I've been working, I might actually be one of the very few people who has seen the amount of wasteland that I've seen and the things that we've left behind as humans, these large areas that have been mined or deforested and then left for dead, basically. So I've gone back and looked at those and brought those back into our consciousness as an extension of our habitats. Because I worked in industry, I thought, wouldn't it be interesting to start bringing my camera into these places and showing these worlds? And then that's how it really began. So I started photographing mining, and then I went to quarries, and then I started looking at factories and oil refineries, and I became fascinated with that idea of going to these worlds to see where all our stuff comes from.
There's a conceptual density to his work. His works, his photographs are instances, examples of his subject. That tension between seduction and repelling subject matter is one that I find absolutely fascinating, and it is consistent in his work. He has been doing it for 40 years, and he makes the same point over and over and over again, and they're not just images, they're actual objects, and they're fascinating. They're extraordinary objects. This is as far as photography has been pushed, technically. And that's something that you don't see when you see his work in books or magazines. You really do have to see an exhibition.
There's like 13 murals, there's 92 60 by 80 prints, and a room dedicated to the In the Wake of Progress.
This is the largest and the most purely photographic exhibition I've ever organized. The largest exhibition of Ed Burtynsky's career.